Hey everybody.
Hello. I am having a dancing Ish next to me, but he will probably deny this because there's no proof.
I would never dance.
Do you believe that he would never dance? Hello, Mom. Hello, Knockers. Thank you for being here. Sorry for not responding sooner, but we were just jamming to this music, right? Isn't this song awesome? The weekend sets the mood. Anyway, I hope you guys are having a fantastic day.
How's it happening in the hibby?
How are the hibbies? Yeah. Do you remember that that's what you guys are called now, hibbies?
So, we figured we don't want to keep doing the same thing over and over and over again.
Even though we had a blast last time.
We did have a blast, and we probably will definitely will come back to trying to not explode in some bombs at some point in the future. But because we want to kind of...
branch out?
I think branch out, but like, but also, prove to you guys that we are not just going to...
Do one thing
and keep it going. Today is just going to be kind of a one-off. And for those of you who are used to kind of games in this genre, you're going to be like, how can you just do a one-off of this? Well, I guess the thing we're thinking is, we're just going to do one. Until you guys tell us you want more.
Yeah, I mean, if you like really like the game that we choose today, and you are down, and you leave comments in chat, or if you're watching this back on YouTube later, you leave comments in the description, or if you DM me on Twitter, either on our official account or on my personal account, because I think most people that are here will have both, and I'm tagged in a lot of them. If you send us messages or tweets, whether they're public or private or whatever, and you say, I loved that game, I need to see more of it, then we'll make that happen. But if you're not really feeling it, and you don't say that, then we're just not going to. We're just going to have a good time, play the things that we like, and just, you know, kind of follow your lead and all work together in this community to make this cast as fun as it can be. So,
Exactly, and I guess the thing we should probably stress is that if you say, we love this, more, it's not going to make us do these nights more often or less often. It's going to be the same schedule that it's always kind of been.
Right, it's probably just going to be like once a week, if that, some weeks, if something really big has come up or something, we might miss a week, but I definitely will be keeping you guys posted about what's going to happen and when it's going to happen and that kind of thing. We're still trying to figure out what our schedule is, and things in our lives are a little bit wonky because we have a lot going on right now. And we know that you guys understand that because you guys have really busy, really full lives with stuff going on. So I will always keep up to date on the Twitter. So if you're not already following the Twitter, I can't stress it enough. Please follow. Oh, bless you. Please follow It's a Hobby World on Twitter.
Yeah, hibbys.
And join the hibby family.
Okay. Well, without any further ado, do you want to let them know what the game is for today?
All right. So we were talking long and hard about what the game should be. And basically what I said is I would like an RPG of some sort, but kind of like older school and kind of interesting. And I suggested a few things, but either Ish had played them on his solo cast already and was kind of like, I don't know that I'm ready to go back there again, or we just weren't sure. And then he came up with a really good suggestion, which is something that I personally have never seen before. I've never played it before. I've only ever heard about it. So,
And as far as I'm concerned, I've never played this version of this game, and this is kind of the last of an era for me. This is the last version of the game that I played. I don't think I've played this in 10, 12 years I've not played this game.
Yeah, so it's going to be really, really interesting and really exciting for you guys. So the game of the day is Pokemon Emerald. So, hopefully, some of you are Pokemon fans, and if you're not, maybe you'll become a Pokemon fan having watched this. And, of course, we're going to have our usual commentary and stuff as well to accompany the game. So, hopefully, it'll all work out, and you will enjoy it. How are we sounding to you in all of those kinds of things? Because it looks from our side like it's great, but it would be really great to have your feedback also. Do we sound good? Are you enjoying yourself? Comfy? How's it all going?
We sound great.
Do we sound great?
We sound great. We sound magnanimous.
Magnanimous?
Yeah, there we go. Word that I can't pronounce.
We're magnanimously fabulous. Woohoo!
So, yeah, like I said before, this is Pokemon Emerald. I have some brief. Internal battery is run dry. I'm gonna start a brand new game for you guys.
We're starting fresh. That guy looks like he's super comfortable.
He's loving life right now. Like, I want to be a professor that just, like, wears shorts.
Seriously, can you be in the lab or anything and just wear, like, shorts?
I don't think so.
No?
That's how you get acid burns, dear.
Oh.
Bad things happen if you just wear shorts.
Oh. The sound is on the Funky Fresh. I'm glad. For a minute there, I thought it was Funky Bad, like funky smell, like gym shorts.
No gym shorts. Sorry to keep you guys waiting.
We are being welcomed into the world of Pokemon.
Professor Finch. Oh, Birch. Everyone calls me Pokemon Professor.
I think we're just going to go with Mr. Tree, because that's a tree name. Birch trees.
He's got a leaf thing with him.
That is one crazy looking creature. I assume it's a Pokemon of some sort.
He told us it was a Pokemon.
See, I'm not even paying attention already to the words. I'm just making my own stories up about what this professor is doing. This is going to be an interesting cast, folks.
So we're not going to read a whole lot of the text until we get kind of into the game. Essentially, Pokemon are kind of our enemies in this battle together. So
our allies or our enemies?
Both.
Oh.
Both.
Hey, Joey, what's up?
So, we're going to see a little bit of us battling Pokemon, us saving the Pokemon.
Oh, that Pokemon, see, Joey has the facts, man, is based off of Mexican folklore.
I actually did know that because, okay, now the memories are starting to flow back. The fully upgraded one of this wears a sombrero.
Oh. I am a big fan of the sombrero. I think that it is a very sexy form of headwear.
We're actually going to ask probably the most important question right away. Do we or do we not have certain parts to our body?
I think we should be full on boy.
Full on boy.
Oh, although the girl was cute. But
oh, you committed already.
I know. We went full on boy.
And you know what that means, right?
Yes, his name has to be Ishifishi.
I don't think we can get Ishifishi in.
Oh, fine. It'll just have to be Ish. We could do Ishi.
We can get Ishi in there.
Yay! Yeah, it's not gonna fit. I don't think so, no.
No, that's not gonna work. No, it's not. Gotta reach
hands. Oh! Okay, let's be a girl.
We're being a girl, okay. Well, you know that means that we have to be. Right?
Yes, Nina who can't make up her mind. Oh, he said Neeners. I don't think it would fit. Would it fit?
I'm gonna try.
Oh my gosh. There we go.
Done.
Joey demands it. Hey, Puri, welcome to the cast. So good to see you.
You're Neeners. You're moving to the little room.
That sounds...
And he understands everything now. And see, and even taste colors.
Okay, but I... Little Root sounds a little bit X-rated to me.
Whoa, are you picking it off of the... This is a children's game, dear.
But I am an adult, so... And, I mean, my mother's my mother. Have you met my mother? I mean, you know, anything with roots are naughty parts, you see.
Anyway. So, we have us in the movie van.
Hang on a second, I have to do something here.
Come back over here, dear.
I'm trying, I'm coming.
No, you gotta come back over here now.
Oh, okay.
Please.
What did I do?
Gotta come back over to what we're doing over here.
Oh.
There we go.
Sorry.
No problem.
Oh, did it not even let it go through? I pressed the allow, I thought.
Anyway.
I tried to let it go through.
Must be tiring riding with our thing. We were forced to ride in the moving truck. We were allowed to sit in the passenger seat. We were forced to ride in the back of the truck with all the stuff.
But that's fun. You can play hide and go seek back there.
But things could fall on us.
You can rifle through the things.
It was a precariously packed truck. We could have died back there. Our mom doesn't really care about us.
Of course she does. Rude. She even has the cute little barrette in her hair and the apron on. She's going to make us lunch. The movers are like behemoth men, dude.
They're men.
They're male things. They have male parts, I'm sure, under their fur.
Can't disagree with that statement. Well, actually, I can. I bet There had to be female of that same genre.
Well, yeah, but they're not there. Why would they be doing the heavy lifting? Girls don't do the heavy lifting if they can help it.
You don't know that. That's kind of,
You say that I'm sexist? Is that what you're trying to say?
I'm just saying that's a little sexist.
He's accusing me of being sexist. Rude. I don't know. I think I'm wearing some sort of weird hat.
Actually, I think it's really impressive that while we were riding in the back, we both just got in the house and everything was already unpacked. See? No one knows what's going on. There are lady diggeroths.
Jeez. Fine, I have been labeled a sexist already. This cast is going swimmingly for me. And I'm wearing a ridiculous hat.
It's like a bandana thing. That'll work, Jim. We need Dad'll be on. We brought you this report from Cuddlebear.
I hope not.
We just missed it.
Oh, good, good, good. I don't mind missing it.
Her dad's friends live down. Professor Birch is a name, Tree Man.
You keep trying to say bad words.
He lives right next door, so you should go over and introduce yourself. What are you doing, man? Story arms of Pokemon. Power science is staggering.
Hey, what about that little kid?
Kid?
We must talk to everybody.
Professor Tree spends all his days in the lab studying. Never spends time with his kids. This professor kind of sounds like a jerk.
Who needs kids when you have science? Oh, hi, we just broke into your house.
Hello, and you are?
We just broke into your house.
Oh, you're our new next door neighbor. It was something about the same age as you are. Someone's excited about meeting a new friend. Go make a friend.
Oh my god, go up into his room? How scandalous.
Heal his Pokeball. Hey, you. Who are you? Oh, you're next door. I don't know that you're a girl. Dad, Professor Tree said that the next door gym leader is a gym leader's kid, so I assumed you'd be a guy. Wow, this team is sexist for its age.
And you're telling me that I'm the sexist one. Hello? Plus, little boys are like that. Do you not remember being a little boy? Did you ever talk to little girls like that? Or did you just avoid them altogether?
Well, it was a different time back then.
Uh-huh.
Like 20 years ago.
Uh-huh.
Get away with that crap.
Uh-huh.
As wrong as it was. In fact, if you didn't do it,
I didn't say girls can't be movers, but how many girl movers do you know? The majority are male, because it's not that we can't do the things, it's that we don't want to, and we don't like to, and it messes up our outfits. So instead, we say, oh, could you please do it? I can't possibly.
There's something going on out there. Oh, didn't ask for help.
Oh, there's a doggy thing chasing his butt.
Hey, help! In my bag, there's a Pokeball. Alright, so this is deep. You're gonna have to make a decision here.
Yeah? Oh, my. I think we should do the one on the far right.
What, the Mudfish Mudkip? Do you want to know what they are?
Oh, first? Yeah, alright, I should probably know what
they are. We need the Wood Gecko Treco.
Uh-huh.
Chick Pokemon Torchic. Or the Mudfish Mudkip.
Alright, the fish is probably not going to help. The thing on the gecko, I guess.
You want the gecko?
Yeah.
Sure?
Yeah.
You want to see what they all look like?
I guess. Yes, I want the gecko. Oh, wait, that's not so bad. Yeah, give me the fish.
See, I knew you wanted the fish.
Joey, are you really going to pick on every single thing that I say today? Just because you can. Rude. Oh, what is going on with the hair there?
Being electric.
That is a hair problem right there. But hey, we've got a fish and we're ready to fight.
We're gonna jump on it. You can actually tell that our fish is a girl? Denoted by the symbol next to its name.
yeah, so they're both girls. Yep. So one of them is just having a,
Don't say it.
Is indisposed.
There we
is
go.
Is that better for you?
The professor.
Yes, you can look cute for every occasion. This is very true. There are probably cute moving outfits, too. It's just there, it is a mostly male profession. From my personal experience. I'm not saying no girl can ever be one. What have we named it?
The real tough part, we gotta name it.
We should name it after people in the chat. Who wants to be a fish? I think we should name it Joey.
Joey it is.
Even though it's a girl. Joey has now had a sex change.
Oh goodness. Joey the girl mudkip.
Hey Shelly, how are you? You came in right as Joey got a sex change. Welcome. Joey is a girl name as well, yes, but it was named after you and you're a dude. You were almost Jolene.
Pulled through a little while ago. But... Hi, neighbor. Already have your own Pokemon?
That is absolutely right, Perry. I agree with you 110%. Oh, yeah, I know. The country song is actually really iconic. A lot of people have done covers, but I think the original is the best, if we're being honest. I don't always go into the world of
So this is
oh my goodness.
Integral for Pokemon. So
they like to hide in the grass?
They hide in the long grass.
So if we go in the grass, Pokemon's gonna come out at us. I think we should do it. Do it.
There we go.
Oh my god, a Pokemon.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a puppy! Oh, I want a puppy! I want a puppy! Oh, this is like Pokemon Go, but better!
We're actually gonna kill this puppy.
Shh! We're just making him faint.
Look at her.
Her. Fine, we're making her faint. Puppy! I want a puppy! Can we get a puppy?
We'll get a puppy sometime. Okay, that's...
You totally want to get a German Shepherd, don't you,
dear? Oh goodness, no German Shepherds.
I think that would kill you.
Puppymon is the best mon. Actually, that is not what I thought it was. I thought it was a different Pokemon. We're gonna fight one more.
Okay. We're down.
With the Cutlass thing.
That's the caterpillar. I have a couple of those on Pokemon Go. It's so cute to see them, like, lower tech. They're adorkable. Love it.
Just spat at us.
Well, you know, sometimes spatting happens.
Well.
It is a really big step, Puri, but I know that you can do it, and we're behind you 110%. And if you need anything, let us know, and we will help in any way that we can. And, oh my gosh, this is a boy. This is a boy one. I wish we had a ball. We could keep it. And that sounded dirty. Why do we want to ball him? We're not teabagging. We're... If we had more Pokeballs, we could save more.
We made it to Oldale Town? Like, 2 steps away from Little Room?
Okay, so we're town hopping. We like to do that.
We're town hopped.
The game is all about handling your balls efficiently.
So, what do we do today? I'm just trying to think. There was something really, well, as you guys know, with it's a hibby world. We don't just like talking about game of, we do actually like talking about other topics while we're playing the game. One of the coolest things you're going to see with this channel as we keep moving forward is that we do that. One of the things that I really like about Barad is we get an opportunity to do a lot of things. And today, we have an opportunity to pick up a game that's based on a movie that's coming out.
Yeah, can I tell them what it is?
You can.
So, a little backstory. Every time we would go to one of our favorite board game shops, it's called I'm Bored. Isn't that a great name for a board game shop? Another puppy! And she's angry! Anyway, every time we would go to this board game shop lately, Ishii would go, I really like this game. I really like this game. And I'd be like, so get it. And he's like, I don't know. I don't know if I should. So finally today I was like, dude, I think you need to take a chance on it. Like, let's just get it. And he was like, okay, sounds good. So we did it and we came home. And we played it, and so it's called Thanos Rising. And has anybody heard of it, first of all? Have you guys heard about it or anything about it? If not, that's totally fine. But so we played it for the first time.
Oh, it's one of those.
It's kind of
thing?
Yeah, it's kind of cool though. I like it. Yeah, it's there's a really cool Thanos figure, and he kind of spins around. You spin him around, and then there are different gems that are like the different jewels that are part of like the whole story that's coming up in the movie. And basically, you are a team leader to start, and so you pick what leader you want to be. Whether you want to be from, like, the Avengers, you want to be from Guardians of the Galaxy, etc. And You begin playing. It's a rolling game, so you do a lot of rolling dice. It's very, very fun. I was really skeptical about it, but I, in the end, really enjoy it.
A cooperative game, you're trying to beat Thanos and his minions before Thanos completes the Infinity Gauntlet. And it plays very quick. It's
I don't
very
think
intuitive.
Deadpool is in it.
Deadpool is not in it. It is just the MCU characters, Marvel Cinematic Universe. It is really, it says Infinity War on the packaging. It's very much supposed to be a tie-in to them. And for those of you who are kind of into the hobby gaming scene, it's made by USAopoly, who are best known for
Monopoly
clones, like Golden Girls Monopoly and
Puppy Monopoly.
Just name it, and they've probably made it.
Yeah. So we were really skeptical that this game was going to be really, really good. However, we had a lot of fun playing it, and I was actually really, really impressed with some of the things that they used in terms of they used cubes that looks a lot like the ones from Pandemic, and they also use gems, and the gems are just like the ones from Ascension. So if you like those games, it's kind of, for me anyway, being the kind of, you know, I've had about a two-year initiation into being heavy into a lot of different kinds of games and a lot of gaming beyond like Monopoly and rudimentary card games. So it's kind of comforting for me to see things like I literally will go, those gems are like the gems from Ascension. And it has nothing to do with the actual game, but it gives me like an excitement about it. Like I recognize that they probably have the same manufacturer and you know what I mean? You notice these different little things. And I was really impressed that a game from this company that's mostly known for the same thing, just a little bit different, did something so different and so unique. And, you know, I kind of was worried that it would be really gimmicky and really like you have to be deep into this universe to like it. I've only just now started seeing some of the movies and knowing who the characters are and stuff, and so even somebody like me can play this game and have a good time, even though I'm not as maybe attached to the universe as, like, Ishii and some other people.
Yeah, and when I was playing the game, I usually try to detach myself from the theme as much as I can. However, the theme in this game, I really like it a lot. A lot of the things feel good with what they do and how they work. And I also like all the characters. And it's a really cool cooperative experience. And it's, I think, we actually played the easiest way to play that game.
Yeah.
Because when you add more players, you're going to get less access to all those heroes.
Yeah, I think it's going to be a lot harder with more people because we only played two-player. But I think that's going to be part of the fun. Because you're going to be in a group setting with friends and you're going to be working together, and so it's less about, you know, oh my god, we've got to win or anything like that. It's more like, hey, let's have a good time, and you can really do that with this game. There's a lot of versatility for that here. And, yeah, I really, really enjoyed it, and I hope that that more people check it out, that it becomes kind of like a hit game, because I think it's worthy of that.
It definitely is a very fun game. I could see myself not wanting to play it. Like, there are other games we have in our collection that I can see myself playing more often. But this game is still good, and I'll play it multiple times. And it's actually one of those games that I can get newer people into. Like, I didn't have very many good cooperative games I can get. I use this scale for whether or not I can... A game is where a game should be in my collection. And I should say our collection. It's whether or not I can teach my parent or somebody who doesn't know anything but Monopoly. How hard is it to teach them to play the game? The thing is this one I would say is probably closer to the
It's a good gateway
game.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's a good gateway game, and I think it's also really really cool because if anybody had an interest in the universe that it takes place in, you can really. You can really enjoy it. We did have pizza for dinner tonight. Donkers, are you, like, psychic? Are you riding our vibe? I may have misheard, but you were getting in on something deep right then. We did have pizza for dinner tonight. Yes, we did.
What else do we have that's really exciting?
A really exciting good game. I think the game that we played yesterday, well, we played two games yesterday, but I think that...
Did?
Yeah, we played Sagrada.
Oh, that's right.
And then we played Cry Havoc. I think they're both, That he does. We established that last night during the Midnight Ride.
beat Brendan, by the way, who's the professor's son on our first try. So we're pretty awesome.
We are pretty awesome. And, you know, he wasn't really nice to us, so he needed to get a little smackdown, you know?
He did need to get a little smackdown.
So we played Sagrada, which I think Sagrada is another really good kind of gateway game. That's really fun to play. It doesn't take a long time. I think a lot of people get frustrated with gaming because some of the games take so long. But I think when you're just easing somebody into board gaming or gaming as a hobby, not going into it so full on is kind of a good thing. And I've noticed that even with video games, you know what I mean? Like, if you're trying to get somebody into video games and you start with an RPG that takes, like, a really long time, sometimes people are like, oh my god, how many hours do I have to devote to this? I can't deal. I need something short, you know? Like, they need, like, a fighting game or something that you can go in and out of to start. But then they're like, well, you know, now that I've played this for a while, I'm a little bit more interested in other things, and then people branch out. I think it's the same thing with board games. You know, you just have to start simple and kind of small and work your way out. And I think,
oh, sweet, we got running shoes.
Cool, we can run away from people faster now. Oh, Ish already did that, Shelly. I can't click the,
You can.
The, but it'll mess up your game.
Fine.
What? Oh. I don't know how to do your thing. There we go. Ish already did that earlier. In the game.
We're gonna go get him. Whee! We can run for hours.
Yeah, we didn't have mods yet.
And I will run so far away.
Couldn't get away. Aw, you didn't do the best part, dear.
I couldn't get away from that. We don't want one of these, do we?
Well, we don't have one, do we?
Do we want one?
Do you want one? I think they're cute. You don't like them?
They look like rabid.
Yeah, but that'll scare the other Pokemon.
It will not scare them.
That's awesome, Shelly. And, Street Fighter, yeah. I've heard such good things about that.
Street Fighter Collection. Tell me more, Piri.
Well, you got Ishii's attention now.
Is it just 1, 2, and 3? Maybe 4?
Now he's got ideas of things he wants to play. Here. Okay, you work on that, kid. Puppy!
You want a puppy, right?
Yes, you totally want a puppy, puppy. I need a puppy.
Or a puppy.
Yeah.
No puppy. I think I'll be able to do this.
Yay!
We're gonna try to get a puppy.
Give us a puppy! We have a puppy!
Oh, 1, 2, and 3 in every arcade version? That sounds pretty cool.
Yeah!
Is Mega Man X Collection coming in? Okay, now we've gone into it.
Oh god, here
Mega
we go.
Mega Man 11 is coming out soon, and I cannot wait for that game to release.
Can I tell you what happened? Can I tell them what happened at the comic store?
We did.
Okay, so we went to a comic store that we had never been to before. And they had, like, a lot of traditional comics and some graphic novels. But the problem is that the graphic novels were not the kind of graphic novels that I like. And, no, we have to name it after people in the chat.
You can't name this one Puppers?
No, this needs to be Shelly.
It can't be Puppers?
No, it has to be Shelly, dear.
Oh, Puppers.
No, its nickname can be Puppers. Shelly the Puppers. That's how we can tell the difference between our Shelly and this Shelly, you see. Hello, hi. Anyway, so, I was a little disappointed in their graphic novel section. But they had a lot of, like, collectibles that were, like, Batman and, like, old Batman comics, but they were, like, $60 a piece for the old Batman comics, and I was like, dude, if I had that much money, I would be spending it on other things, but oh my god, it's Batman. And they had so many Batman things that I was kind of, like, in love. And so then we were trying to decide if there was anything that we needed or that we really, really wanted. And our puppy of love. We're naming all of the Pokemon after people in chat. So we already have a Joey, and now we have a Shelly.
So we went to the comic store?
Yeah, so we were at the comic store, and we were about to, like, you know, we were getting ready to leave. And all of a sudden, Ishii saw these little Mega Man figures.
Tiny.
Really tiny ones.
And it wasn't even... Sorry. I'm gonna jump in. They were blister packs.
Yeah. And he was like, okay, I'm gonna get three, and we're gonna hope and pray that there are not any duplicates, that it's all just, you know, legit okay. So, we went ahead and got those, and can I tell you, yes, the blind figures. Can I just tell you that there were no duplicates? We were able to get an original Mega Man.
Yeah.
We were able to get, what was the other dude's name?
Do do do, do do.
Oh my god.
Do do do, do.
There's music.
Do do do.
There's music. That helps me nothing.
That's okay. Somebody will help us out.
Do you know who that is? Because I don't. I just know what they looked like. There we go.
See? I did okay.
And then what was the last one?
The last one was a Fireman.
Yes, it was Proto Man and Fireman. And the original Mega Man. And he was so happy because he's like, the two that I wanted was original Mega Man and Proto Man. My life's complete. And I had wanted a cute little...
You wanted a beep.
Or what was the other thing that looked cute that was right above it?
A roll.
Okay, whatever. Something...
A rush, sorry.
Whatever, it was cute. And
you wanted the dog or
yeah,
the dog rush or the bird beep.
Yeah. And it totally didn't happen. We got Fireman instead. So I felt a little gypped. But...
Do we want this?
I'm glad he got the things that he did. Oh, they're so cute! I have like 50 of them on Pokemon Go because they're so, like, weaselly and easy to get. I think we should just kill it.
We just want to kill it.
When we find something cuter, we can do it. Because I think the next one should be Puri, if we can. We need to find a girl thing, and it needs to be cute so we can make it Puri. Sorry, I'm having Pokemon standards now. See what you started? I have weird Pokemon standards.
I don't understand why we have weird standards, but okay.
Well, because I'm insisting on a girl Pokemon, and it must be cute because it's Puri's Pokemon.
Oh, Puppers leveled up.
Yay, we leveled our puppy!
Saying this can't be Puri?
I don't think that can be Puri. No. The female... What? Rats? Rapes? Rapes? What?
I think that's what I'm going for, period.
If it were a boy, I would say that that could have been Knockers, but...
Oh.
Because of the sombrero later!
Oh, the sombrero later. I can't even remember how to get a sombrero. Also, I'm not gonna try to look up anything for this game. It's gonna be awesome.
Memory and grinding and fun.
I don't like the raccoon.
I know you don't. But it could have been Mom. I mean, would Mom really be upset with being a fuzzy raccoon? No, you think she'd be upset with that?
Might not work well.
Okay. Mom can't be a fuzzy raccoon. We're naming people after the Pokemon we're playing. And... We thought you wouldn't want to be a fuzzy raccoon.
Well, we got rid of the fuzzy raccoon anyway.
She said she could be fuzzy.
Could be fuzzy?
So if we find something fuzzy... Cute when they're not doing bad things. We have some that live by our dumpster. I don't think we've ever told them the stories of the raccoons that live by the dumpster.
Do you know what happens to that raccoon?
It becomes a big raccoon.
It becomes a ferret.
Oh, it does?
If I remember correctly.
Ferrets are weaselly little things, but they're kind of cute.
My friend played... This is the one vivid memory I have of this game.
Uh-huh.
My friend ground this game to bits. Didn't cheat, didn't use a game chart, didn't do anything like that. He had a level 100, which is the highest level you can get for these things, and you have to go for it, you know. The level 100, whatever that thing turns into.
Raccoon, yeah.
The raccoon turns into a ferret. And dear God, if that ferret wasn't the most fucking annoying thing that he had on his team.
Okay, well then it's a good thing we didn't make that Mom, because then Mom would be the most annoying thing on our team, and we don't want that. Is it Knockers? Oh, I think it's Knockers.
No, it can't be.
Why not? Oh, you have something in mind for Knockers?
I don't have anything in mind for Knockers.
But he could get a sombrero, dear.
I just really don't like this thing.
Fine. Be all aggro. We gained experience.
We got a level.
I know, isn't it cute? Bouncy, 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 bouncy. We don't have boobs, so we have hair that bounces.
I guess.
Some people like bouncing boobs, some people like bouncing hair. It all depends on what you want. Okay, fine. We accept your challenge.
We're taking him down.
Look, he looks like a little snot. Doesn't he?
Oh, it's a pupper.
If we see a Mr. Mime, that's Nako.
Oh, come on, guys.
I have no idea what these things are.
Don't touch that with a 10-foot pole.
I don't know what we're talking about. Mom's a jinx? I don't know what's going on.
No. No, just leave it be.
Mom is adorable like a Pikachu.
Oh, we're taking out some bug Pokemon.
Oh,
it's
yeah?
Time to bug out.
Oh, it's one of those. They're annoying, and they're usually very weak. Pokemon Go anyway. What the hell did he just do?
Spat on us.
Stop spitting. What is he, a llama now? Or a horse? Did I ever tell you guys the story about my encounter with the horse that spat all over me?
You did tell me.
It was very traumatizing as a child. Have I shared it with the group? See, what happened was, I was at the fair with my aunt, and my dad was off somewhere doing whatever it was he was doing. He left us alone for about an hour. I don't even want to know. Anyway, I was about 4 or 5, maybe 6, in that range. And I loved horses. So there were these horses that were corralled in this small little corral area. And it was right before the cows for the 4-H section. They had just this random thing with like these two horses. And there was this one horse that was beautiful. It was like white with like little black patches. And I just thought it was the most gorgeous looking horse ever. And it was friendly. It was coming over to me. And so you could buy feed to give to like all the animals, and they had like special feed or whatever that you could treat the horses if you, you know, put in like a quarter.
Sure.
So I begged my aunt, can we please do it for the horsey because horses are my favorite, let's do this. And she was like, yeah, totally awesome, I'm down. So we did it, and so I had this feed in my hand. And I took it from, like, the little baggie, and I was like, here you go, horsey. And he came over and slobbered all over my hand. And I literally looked at my aunt in terror, like, oh my god, I have, like, horsey drool going down, like, my fingers.
Got a new Pokemon.
Yay!
Gonna have to kill.
And so, ooh, that's kind of cool. And so, I was grossed out completely, and then my aunt was cleaning off my hands, and I heard a noise, so I turned because my hand just got cleaned because she had, like, you know, wipes in her purse and stuff like that, you know. So I turned to look at where the noise is coming from, and it was the horse coming back, and he grabs a hold of my shirt, which is white, by the way. And starts, like, spitting on it and chewing on it. And I'm like, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, he's gonna kill me, he's gonna kill me. Because he's pulling me towards the, you know, the corral that he was in. Mm-hmm. And my aunt's like, oh my god, oh my god. So she pulled me back and he let go. But there was all, like, horsey drool and spit up.
You got spit on.
All over my shirt. And so we had nothing else to wear. So literally it starts to rain at that moment, so, like, most of the chunky parts fell off, but I had these, like, brown stains on my shirt the whole rest of the day, and that's my story. Of course he spit it all over my white shirt. It was a very traumatizing thing for me. I was very grossed out and very upset that we did not bring a change of clothes for me, because why don't I have a change of clothes? Or, we were at the fair, there were other t-shirts, let's buy a new t-shirt. But my dad was like, no, you're fine. Meanwhile, where was he for that hour? We will never know.
And there's a lot of people to battle on this first route.
I know, right? Oh, she's cute, too. I like her skirt.
She likes raccoons.
I still like her skirt. I have no idea if that's what he was doing during his time. Oi.
Hey. I want one of those.
Oh yeah, who's that gonna be? Is that Knockers?
Sure. Owner.
That's other mommy.
Unfortunately, it's somebody else's. Can't have that one.
Why not? Aww. Why can't it be other mommy?
Oh shit.
What, is it killing us?
Yeah, it's... I forgot that it had that ability. We got it, though.
We almost died.
Well, we leveled up. We're good. We learned water moves now. We made it to the next city.
Yay! He lives for Pokemon, huh?
Who owns the stuff? What's he reflecting on our face? Need to know. That hope? That fear?
I think it's... Oh my god, what's happening to my face? I think it's being split apart.
Fear.
I just wanted to thank you guys for being here, by the way, and if you're not already subscribed to the channel, what are you waiting for? Feel free to subscribe. Also, feel free to follow us on Twitter at It's a Hobby World, because we would love to have you get our tweets when we tweet out we're going to be streaming, and we would love to be able to hear your thoughts on things and communicate with you guys through there as well as here in the chat. So feel free to follow those things. We are going to be getting some graphics soon, so that'll be really exciting to be able to show you guys and have set up.
Got a potion. Just lay it on the ground. Just does that.
Somebody who doesn't care about their potions. We care about our potion.
Care about it.
Maybe we'll get something nice. Another puppy! The growly puppy. It's a girl puppy, so does this mean that we're making her our bitch?
I don't know about that. Can't comment.
but she's a girl puppy, and that's what girl puppies are called.
Well, I understand.
Is that Knockers?
Nope.
No.
I know, we need to find more Pokemon, but there's one in particular we're looking for.
Oh, you've got a specific thing in mind.
I got something in mind, because I remember.
So does anybody remember the one Pokemon, thing that I played back in the day with Mystic Seeker? Does anybody remember that era of games and that time period? Does anybody remember? Because some of you were around during that. So this is like a Nina the Wizard quiz moment. Quizzes with Nina!
Wow.
But it's Prickly and Spitzgoo. How could it not be Nocco? It was the extra bonus bits in Pokemon Stadium. Yep, Joey remembers. The Lickitung thing, and the burrowing thing, and then wasn't there one with jumping, like, in a boat?
I think
there was something with jumping in a boat, and we would play those all the time. Very good on remembering. And that was all I knew about Pokemon until I started playing Pokemon Go. And then I was like, oh, that thing is cute. Yeah, the Lickitung sushi game. You do, Shelly? Oh, that is so awesome. He has a copy of that.
We do too.
Do we? Oh, but you never play it with me because you don't like those games. Grr!
Well, that and our N64 controller is kind of boring.
Well, then we need to get a new one.
It's hard to find a good one.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Right, because remember we went to that one store?
Yep.
And they were just the knockoff ones, and they looked really unreliable.
Well, I picked up the knockoff one, and it breaks really quickly.
Yeah.
Not even being too rough on it, just the...
Make them, the quality isn't there?
Well, it's not built the same way they used it. I feel like I'm not in the right spot, but I also feel like I am in the right spot.
Something kind of interesting that we're talking about games and older games and systems and things. Ishii and I have had this running thing where if we ever found a copy of Super Monkey Ball, we would get a GameCube so that we could get other games, obviously, after that. But if we found that one particular game, because that's my favorite game on that system, it means a lot to me. And it's special to me, then we would get, like, the system, you know, and everything else. So, literally, we have been on a mission to find it in stores, and every store we come across is, like, every other game. Like, other games that we like and think are cool for that system, but not that one particular game. Because nobody wants to give it back, because, you know, or sell it, or get, you know, or, you know, let it go. So... that's like my goal, my mission. So I literally look so hard to try to find it every time we go, especially to one of our favorite stores, which is called Game On. I just have to say that, like, our friends in this area that have stores are really great at naming their stores. Like, there's I'm Bored, there's Game On. Like, there are just some really great names. Anyway, but at Game On, they have a lot of, like, you know, systems and games and stuff, and so every time we go there, I'm like, is it there? And he's like, no, not this time, and I'm like, oh, so sad, so
we
sad.
We found it.
This is Knockers?
No.
Oh, this is Puri.
Yes.
We found Puri.
Don't die.
Can we not die?
Don't die. There we go. Throwing balls at it.
Okay. Let's get our Puri. Get our Puri. Oh, we got a Puri!
Ooh.
To look into that game, Joey. I'm unfamiliar, but I am sure I will.
Yes.
I will like it because you're very good at the recommendations.
Found a GameCube, shall I? Please.
Someday when we move, whenever that happens to be, whether it be in like 5 years or 5 months, no matter when it is, I really want to set up again that's hooked up to the PS2 Because I miss sharing the PS2 games with everybody on cast.
Mm-hmm.
Because we were having some fun playing The Thing. And my feeble attempts to play, Ratchet and Clank?
Yep.
Yeah, my feeble attempts to play that were horrible. I made everyone go, what the heck is she doing? She's lost her mind. Oh my gosh, I have to find my, DS. And
what could it be?
It's in here somewhere. It's just, it's dead. I have to find the charger to it.
We bought an extra one, didn't we?
What, charger for that? No, we only had an extra charger for,
Oh, we bought an extra charger for that.
No.
It'll turn up eventually.
I'm telling you, they're all in this room.
Uh-huh.
I just don't know where in this room they are. The kitty is also in this somewhere.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I don't believe that.
No, I took the kitty out to use the frame.
Yeah.
The kitty in a safe place. Now I can't remember where the safe place is. But, we definitely have a... We definitely have one. I mean, I definitely know that it's in this room or whatever, but anyway, I have to get back into my Animal Crossing.
Animal Crossing is good.
It is addictive. And Nook is a boss, man. He upcharges everything. He owns everybody.
Everyone.
That's a raccoon on a mission, man. Enterprising! Oh, we were watching, you know that channel that does all the lists of things?
Oh, don't tell them we were watching that. That'll ruin our swag.
Anyway, and they had the most annoying anime girls or whatever, and it made me think of Joey because he had said how much he hated this one girl from this one anime. And she was really high up there on the list of annoying girls. I think she's also in Worst Girlfriends, too, if I'm not mistaken. No, it's the girl from, oh, it starts with an O.
A sister?
Yeah.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah. The sister who falls in love with her brother and sabotages all of his relationships? Yes. There we go. Yes. And she automatically made me think of Joey, because Joey was like, that's a horrible thing, I hate her. And he, like, we, like, had, like, a 20-minute conversation just about his loathing her. And so now every time I see her, I think of Joey, like, instantly, because I'm like, she annoys him so bad. Oh my, the disdain is oozing from his pores. I think we've hit a nerve there.
So, what we're doing right now is we're trying to just level up on the thing that we're trying to level up, period.
Uh-huh.
Because right now all she can do is growl at things and not hurt them.
Okay.
Where's the raccoon?
Oh my goodness. Thank you.
So, what else happened? I did pre-release this weekend.
Yes, you did. Dominaria seems like a really fun set for Magic the Gathering.
The Magic the Gathering set Dominaria came out. Ton of fun. Like, if you are at all interested in Magic the Gathering and have some friends you can play with, buy a couple packs and just play sealed. Kind of with each other. That is. Dominaria is a very fun set. One of the funnest things I like about Dominaria is they harken back to everything that happened on the planning through Magic, through this new expansion. So, I don't know how much you were aware of this, but Dominaria takes place pretty much from... There's the Ice Age, there's Mirage, there's Weatherlight, there's Visions, there's Tempest, there's... Pretty much name everything you can on probably about Aridin? Ravnica? It was before Ravnica. Maybe Aridin was before Ravnica. Original Aridin. It was before Original Aridin. Right after the Urza's block would be the last of Dominaria. And I think it was Meriden right after that. That was the first time in Magic's history that they'd gone to a different plane. So that happened in about 2000. No. Like 2003, 2004 era. But from 95 to 2004, we were all in the same plane. There was an Ice Age, there were places going in and out of the plane. And they talk about all of it throughout, like, little hints. There's like a thing called the Triumph of Gerard. If you read the books or even read the story, Gerard's a major character in it.
It was not Joey. It's more mainstream than that. I think that's why she doesn't want to divulge. And I have not seen it yet. We've been watching Fairy Tail lately, trying to catch up for the new stuff that's going to be coming. I have not even heard of it, period, but I'll definitely check it out. And I am going to take a quick break, personally. So I will be back, everybody. I'm sure that she can entertain me.
Thank you.
Hello. How do you have to deal with me? I have no brakes on the train of training Puri. Actually, there might be some brakes on the train of training Puri now. I'm glad you got done getting some dinner in. It was important to eat. Alright, let's check out the gym. Can't be that scary, can it? Huh. Oh, Wally.
We're going to show Wally how to catch Pokemon. I think Wally, like, immediately finds a Ralts.
Yep.
I gotta watch this thing tackle him. Catch the damn thing, Wally. Gotta show 4 gym badges to that guy in order to challenge him. Excuse me, let me guess, from the way you're dressed, a Pokemon trainer? Leaving footprints in the sand is so fun. Woo! Welcome back.
Are you taking a second? Oh, I didn't miss anything too much.
Well, we helped Wally, this random person.
Uh-huh.
We saw our dad, the gym leader.
Is he a tool or is he good? We like him.
Well, he pretty much told us we suck and we can't see him until we get stronger.
Sounds like my real one. So far, the scenario is going really good. Thank you, Mom. Yeah, we've tried sausage and peppers here, but Ishii's not really into onions. And onions are a big part of it.
Or peppers.
So it was kind of like not his bag. He was like, I'd kind of rather just have spaghetti, to be honest with you. See, I thought the sausage would be the clincher that would really make it go over, but it wasn't enough because of those other two things. So.
We're howling a lot. We're going to get super.
from you.
I just want us to find Mom and Knockers here. I feel like we're leaving them out.
I'm working as fast as I can to get there.
Oh, it's cool. It's cool. I'm not trying to rush you. I'm just saying.
We've only been on the first route, too.
Oh, wow. Cool. Well, that kind of explains some things, then.
100.
I'm sorry it took me so long.
No big deal.
Ulsi and Minuit? Question mark?
That'd be a kind of cool one. So there's one that's a plus Pokemon and one that's a Pokemon.
Ah. And together they make perfectness. Have you had other thoughts?
I don't have any other thoughts.
I thought you had a plan, man. For Knockers.
I don't have a plan for Knockers. I got it.
What is this? Oh my god, we need it!
Need it?
This could be you, dear.
I don't want this.
Why not?
Why can't this be Knockers?
I suppose he has other mommy.
Are you sure you want it?
No, because nobody wants to claim it. I think it's pretty.
Taking her out then.
Okay. It's just we don't have a birdie. Yuri can confuse.
Yuri is gonna confuse. Picking berries.
That sounds sexy. Fury says he's going to be the strongest attacker by level 30.
That's probably true. Well, there's a new Pokemon, a water Pokemon that he fished up.
Yeah, but how good is it not in the sea?
Well, about as good as it is in the sea.
That stinks. It shouldn't be like that.
doesn't do anything.
Oh, okay.
We're gonna murder it.
Murder dead fishy! The delicacy in some places. So intrigued by this game. So, is everybody enjoying this game? What are your thoughts? Do you have any thoughts on if we should play this again in the future, or if we should do something totally new and make it just a complete one-off? What are your thoughts and feelings? Not that we're ending the cast or anything, but I'm just curious what your thoughts are at this point. Nostalgia.
Run so far away.
Oh, Fury says beat the game. And Mom says it's an awesome surprise.
Awesome surprises.
So I think people are down for this game. She is so pretty. I don't want to kill her. Oh, yes, I do.
She has a raccoon.
She's hiding a raccoon underneath her skirt. What's going on with that? She had a long skirt. Knocker says everyone seems to love it, so keep on going. I think this is a pretty, pretty steady. This game should be here for a while. Which is fantastic to hear because we weren't sure if people would enjoy it. She is gorgeous. I did like her dress. I thought it was really pretty. I just don't know why there are raccoons up under it.
Whoa!
Are we dead?
Shelly died.
Shelly, you fainted! Oh, Mom says, oh my god, a furry under her dress. Mom's taking it to a whole new level. Should I not be this way?
Well, it's fine.
Is it disturbing you?
Is it comfortable to you?
Yes.
Go ahead,
enjoy it. Oh, it lasts.
Yep.
Can we fix Shelly so he's better?
We can. It's gonna take a while.
Okay.
And we will.
Poor Shelly needed to snooze.
Didn't know this. We were just gonna get tackled for 18 points of damage. That's very uncommon. Parachute crits.
Welcome to the Universal Pokemon Healthcare System.
It's all free over there.
See, we missed our calling as Pokemon. So here's an interesting question. If you were a Pokemon of your choice from any generation, what would you be and why? This also goes to you, dear.
Oh, it goes to me?
Mm-hmm, also. As well as chat.
I like Dragonite, Gen 1.
That's who you'd be?
I'm just thinking.
Uh-huh, out loud.
I only know Gen 1, 2, and 3.
Uh-huh.
I remember the Dragonite was pretty cool. Rayquaza is pretty cool from Gen 3.
I think my answer would surprise you.
Fighting.
Creepy looking man with a hat.
Creepy looking man with a hat wants to fight.
Of course he does, he's a creepy man.
He's bugging out.
Oh. It happens. Oh, he's got knockers.
What? You've already made it knockers? That's what knockers is gonna do?
No, no, no. It's just funny to say because it spits on people. Anyway, what do you think I would be, dear?
I got nothing.
Well, maybe I'll tell you once you make up your mind that you would be.
I don't know, I like Gengar too.
Aw, that's really cool. Can somebody get us a picture of it? Maybe? Because I've never seen one, I don't think.
I also have not.
They just went all buggy.
Spit. That's all they did. They just sit and spit.
Sounds like a llama. Yeah, I'm gonna touch you. Here, stop moving. Put this damn place and let me touch you.
No.
Why?
It's hot.
You're hot, but that's not the point.
Hey.
It's true. Anybody else in chat think they could rustle up a picture for us? While I attempt to touch Ishii? I touched you!
Yeah.
Ha 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 ha! I caught you in my own form of a Pokeball. What?
Relax.
I was relaxed. You just hate the way I'm sitting for some reason.
You keep poking me.
I poked you with my foot on purpose. I liked it. I like to use it. All in favor of me poking Ishii as much as possible, please say aye in chat. A picture of the Pokemon that Puri would be, if Puri could be any Pokemon. Speaking of which, Mr. over there.
Gengar.
Okay, why?
It's cool.
Okay.
He's a badass. And I can put you to sleep and eat your dreams forever.
You heard it here first. Puri said a Silvion? Is that how you pronounce that?
Again, this is the last generation of Pokemon that I played. Oh! We found it! I want it.
There you go. Don't kill it.
Who wants to be it?
Well, Joey said that's what he would be, but we already gave Joey one, so I say it's Knockers. It's either you or Knockers. Do you want it, Ishii?
I'll take it.
Okay, Ishii is going to be the shroom. Okay, guys, one moment after this. Did we get it? Did we get it? Did we get it? Is this Ishii? It is Ishii. And Ishii is going to... It's not going to stretch out though.
I know.
Oh, it is gorgeous. I see. Mm-hmm.
Oh, man. I can't believe I forgot about Snorlax.
I know, you could have been a Snorlax. Well, you could make this be, make this be Knockers. You can be a Snorlax.
Oh, Snorlax, I don't think exists.
Oh, it doesn't? That's sad. Snorlax is one of his favorites. We're gonna get a squishy one that we can cuddle at some point. We just have to win the lottery first, because they're really expensive. Snorlaxes. Everywhere we go.
Those are the small ones.
Is she with an eye?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's not?
No, it's with a Y.
Why? I don't know.
Snorlax is in all gens.
It is.
And you might have two Pokemans. my god, if we know anybody who crossed it, she could get a pattern for Snorlax. We could have, like, that kind of Snorlax.
Yeah?
Yeah. You know what I would really like?
What?
For when Ishii's gone and I'm by myself. Rude! These people here in this game are being rude. Anyway. I need a body pillow of G-Dragon for when Ishii's not here. So G-Dragon and I can be alone.
Oh god. Team Aqua.
And cuddle. You can do it, dear.
Look at that. Team Aqua wants to kick our butt.
I kind of like the color scheme on the clothing.
They got an angrier puppy than we have.
Well, we have a fish. Does our fish mean nothing? Our fish is higher level than they are.
Fish is. Fish.
Come on, Joey. Speaking of agua, that water was delicious. Hydration is the key.
Slapped him with mud.
Well, you know, sometimes you just need a little mud to the face.
Shelly leveled up.
Yay, Shelly!
You learned Sand Attack.
Shelly's doing all the things. Grr! They girded us. And then ran away.
Ooh, that was awfully close. Like stick a little, and rub yeah. And putting papers on. I'll give you a great ball as my niece. We got a great ball.
What is a great ball? Does that mean it's a particularly large ball?
It's better for catching higher level Pokemon.
Ooh! With the fancies! Getting fancy with it. You didn't want to go to the gym?
No, I want to go to the gym. We already got a Shroomish. Oh, look at it.
There are so many angry. Yeah, that kind of does fit. You make that face like you're angry even when you're not angry. It's just the thing. It's hereditary.
It's not nature is jelly.
Yeah, you're happy, but you look like you're pissed off and want to punch people in the face. It's just a thing. Even... Your cousin's baby has it, uh-huh. Even though she's adorable. She looks like she's gonna beat people up in her sleep. It's beautiful. I would hate to be the dude that tries to, like, date her. You're gonna be so badass when you reach level 23.
Oh, man.
Are you excited for level 23? Why are you just avoiding the grass? Avoiding the grass. Do some things.
What's in the grass?
That thing! Oh my god, it's pink! We need to get it. That can be Mom.
I don't think Mom will like what it turns into.
What does it turn into?
I think it turns into a moth.
Is Hey, Phantom, welcome! Welcome to the chat! Oh, it turned into a moth. Well, moths are kind of like butterflies, right? Pretty. Oh, it's a poisonous moth? Hey, Mom could be like, don't F with me, man. Don't get in my way. I'll mow you down. No? Nobody's feeling it? Nobody's feeling it. I just thought because it was like a pinky lavender color, it would be perfect, but no. Yes, it sort of is. Joey, I can't hit allow right now, but yes, it sort of is.
Resting grump face, actually.
Resting grump face, he says. Yeah, thanks for that. Yeah, let's bug out, man.
Bugging out.
I just think our hair needs some work. It's like, what's going on here? Seriously. What are we doing?
What the fuck is that?
A ninkata. Oh, is it like a cicada?
It's kind of
cool. Oh, Higurashi. Joey, what's the name of my favorite person from Higurashi again? Her name's escaping me right now. You know, the one that both Mystic and I love. What's her name? Doing, Phantom? It's so wonderful to have you here. How's your night going? Oops.
Great.
No, was it? What does she look like, Piri? I'm so confused right now. Think. I never did finish Higurashi either, which is another thing I have to rectify. It's the cute little one that's not the littlest one. That has like the cute hair. And I can't say like things happen to her several times, because things happen several times to a lot of people in Higurashi.
Did you see the flying ducks?
I did see that. Did we capture it? Rika! Rika! There we go. Rika. Rika's my favorite. Thank you.
Pure's down.
Rika's my favorite.
Oh, no. He's not.
Puri is not down. Puri is beautiful and wonderful. We should capture the cicada.
Yeah.
Oh, fine. We'll just kill it.
It hurt itself. It killed itself.
Rika is my favorite. And I cried many a time so far in Higurashi because bad things keep happening. And tragic. I mean, the knife out of the wall. No more needs to be said. The knife in the wall. Gets me every time.
The knife in the wall.
I feel a little emosh. Be honest with you. See, this one isn't the pretty lavender color.
I think this one turns into a butterfly.
Does it? Oh, that could totally be mommy. I haven't gotten that far, man. We need to rectify this. Joey, we have to finish Madoka Magica. Joey and I have like 5 anime we've got to finish. We have to finish Black Butler, Madoka Magica, Higurashi, and then he said
But if I watch Madoka Magica, he would watch Yuri on Ice with me, and I haven't finished Yuri on Ice. I'm down for starting
Isn't
it over.
Isn't that just a movie?
No, Yuri on Ice is a whole series.
Oh.
What's a whole series?
Are we capturing this thing or no?
We'll have to add that too. Yeah, we should. I will totally look into that, Puri, because I am down. I'm launching on my own because Ishii won't do it. Food Wars.
Well, we got other stuff to watch.
Well, yeah. Just, I know you're not really into it because they over-sexualize a lot.
A lot.
And that really wigs you out.
Well, it just makes no sense. Terrible.
But the thing is, like, around that, like, aside from that, it's really good.
Take a word for it? Are we naming this thing something?
Yeah. That's Ooh. Mom. Huh. So, we could just name it Annie.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What's her abilities?
Oh.
Not gonna go into too much detail on that.
Okay.
Pretty pedal followers, right?
I was also told that I need to watch Dragon Ball Super, but I haven't gotten around to it yet. Has anybody else seen Dragon Ball Super? Yeah, I stopped after I saw a few episodes of GT. I dropped it, and I haven't been back to Dragon Ball since, but I heard that Super is amazing, and I should check it out. But I definitely want to watch those anime with Joey and finish that, and then I started a little anime project on my own. That's insane that I'll probably talk about on my solo cast. And people will go, what is wrong with you that you're doing this? But I think it's kind of fun. Yeah, I did not like GT at all. I dropped it after like 3 episodes. I couldn't take anymore. I just literally could not handle it. A lot of people have told me that I should watch Persona 5. Yeah. It's definitely on my list. I actually updated my anime list the other day. And I've been having it open because I've been doing some anime things. But I'm looking forward to a lot of stuff. Yeah, I felt really upset with GT. Yeah, it just didn't feel right to me. I couldn't get into it, and I was such a huge fan of Z. It's kind of funny, because I was very close to somebody who would watch that with me, like, nightly. So we would watch Dragon Ball Z, like, nightly, and sometimes we would binge-watch some episodes, you know, like, we'd watch it on TV. But then we would go and we would find, like, other episodes because, you know, TV wouldn't necessarily put it in, like, in, you know, the right order for me to have started off with it, if that makes sense. So we would, like, catch up to what was on TV off, you know, on our own. And it's one of the happiest memories being around that person because they were actually in a good mood. We could talk about things. Like, it felt, like, normal. You know, like, just being normal, like, friends chilling kind of thing. And so, I have always really loved Z because that's where I fell in love with Bulma, who is my absolute favorite. I love Bulma more than anything. universe. So I fell in love with her. And I also kind of love Vegeta. He's fun. I like him a lot. So, I hope that, Super is as awesome as people are hyping it up to be. And I've gotten quite a few people recommending that I look into it at some point, so I'm hoping.
Oh!
What?
Guess what, I should have known this. Guess what, starts next week?
Oh, I know.
Been looking into that?
It's the movie.
It is the movie.
Well, because I remembered the date from the last movie we saw.
That's true.
And I was waiting for you to say something about it. We should probably definitely get tickets in advance.
Want to see it? Like it's going to be like that?
I'm saying it's going to be crazy for the first couple weeks. So if you want to see it in the first couple weeks, we're going to have to get a ticket ahead because you saw what happened the last time.
Yeah, we were even watching. We just watched Black Panther last weekend?
Yeah, because we talked about it when we did our cast.
It was still a full theater.
Yeah, I mean, we had to, like, order our tickets ahead of time just to get good seats and be able to get tickets. Because the first time we went just to the theater without getting tickets ahead of time, and we couldn't get tickets. So, I definitely feel like the Infinity War is going to be...
Oh, it's going to be nuts.
It's going to be like that as well.
Hype is going to be super high.
Well, because people, I mean, it's a really popular franchise.
Well, it's part of the culmination.
Yeah, I'm told a lot of things go down, but no spoilers, so that's not spoileration it.
Well, not spoileration it, but they set out to do in the first MCU. Also, don't spoil it for us, is I think what you mean, right?
Yeah.
Don't say what happens.
Oh, Joey hasn't seen anything since the second Thor.
Oh. Ways.
I think I saw the first Thor. How many are there?
Three.
Three? So I've seen one and three. I missed the second one.
This is going to be our last fight for the night.
Alright.
Dapper Rich Boy wants to fight.
Yeah, we saw Ragnarok in the theaters.
Who tackled me, sir? Goon?
I love Batman, but I kind of feel like Suicide Squad didn't represent well, and I also was not into that whole Batman versus Superman nonsense, because I don't like Superman. So I just tuned out. And plus, I'm sorry, but he is not my Batman. I'm very particular about my Batman.
You don't like Batfleck?
No, I am not. I did not get down. Don't be dissing DC. That's my other boyfriend. We already discussed this. I have a few fantasy boyfriends, and Batman is one of them. We also mentioned G-Dragon. He's one of them.
Oh, a lot of boyfriends. Why are you losing four stores?
I know, but as I said on the Midnight Ride the other day, you're my favorite.
Duh.
Because you're real.
Duh.
Even if they were real, I would still choose you. Don't you love the Mooshy Mooshies? Oh, Joey thinks that Batfleck would be amazing in the hands of a good director. It was bad direction, he thinks. That's because DC is Batman's biatch. Should be BC. Batman cane. That's right. I hear ya, I hear ya. So he's all like, you gotta die, raccoon. Wow. I'm not feeling it.
Alright, we got Winston. Oh.
Winston? I like Winston's suit. Oh no.
Never mind, I thought it was the last battle.
I think we're gonna have one more battle, everybody. Oh, she has a cute outfit, though. Can we just appreciate her outfit? Oh, she's got one of those things. Oh my god, Teen Titans the movie? No, that makes me sad, man. I used to watch that show. Can anybody guess who my favorite was? Who do you think was my favorite Teen Titan?
Raven.
Damn you, you're not supposed to know these things.
Oh.
Did I ever tell you that?
Never did.
But who did everybody think that I was most like?
Starfire.
Yes.
There were only two girls in that show.
I know, but it annoyed me so much. I was like, why can't I be like Raven? Your personality's too happy for that. I'll show you happy. Come closer to me. I'm a New Yorker. Put him up. But Raven was my favorite. I think another reason that I was not really for Starfire is because they had the whole, like, romance-y angle with the dude.
Was it Starfire?
Yeah. Something Fire. Whatever her name was. I just didn't like that romance-y thing. Like, Raven was just like, I don't like any of you, but I kind of do, so I'll put up with you. Let's get stuff done. I kind of liked that. She wasn't, you know, all about that. They couldn't... Yeah, Starfire and Robin, yeah, were a thing. But you got that vibe even in the cartoon. Like, they were trying to make it that way, and it just was too much for me. I couldn't handle it. I did like Beast Boy because he made me laugh. I did like him. I thought he was cute. And during that time, I used to also watch Ed, Edd n Eddy. My favorite was Eddie.
Double D?
Eddie.
Alright.
Double D.
Jerk?
Yeah. I have a thing for those. The only person I have ever liked that's not like that is you. And maybe my first boyfriend. But he ended up being one in the end at that time. Hopefully he's matured since then. But yeah, you're the first, like, totally awesome, well-rounded human I've dated.
Oh, they would call me well-rounded queen.
I mean, I did like Double D, but I liked Eddie because he was so just like himself. Like, even when it didn't look good, or it wasn't, and people could, like, hate him, he was himself anyway, and I really, like, admired that about that character, you know what I mean? Like, even when he was wrong, he was himself, you know? And then his friends would be like, you know, bro, that's not cool, or, dude, and then they just move on. Like, I loved the fact that they were all friends and they were able to do that. That is rude, Joey. I would deny that if I were accepting and denying things.
Alright. Well, with that, I think that's going to be it for us for the night.
All right, well, I've had a fun time. Have you had a fun time?
I had a blast. I hope you guys have had a blast, too. If you'd like to see anything...
Ooh, can we do that other song by him that I really like? You know, the one that starts with an S. And a T. Yeah, at the end.
That one.
Yeah.
Sure.
Oh, another one that's with them. No wonder.
Yep. Alright. Well, again, it was great hanging out with you guys tonight. We'll probably continue this in the future.
Sounds good.
Might not be like an every time thing, but it'll definitely keep moving.
And don't be surprised if you see this on our official YouTube. Links will be posted on our Twitter, so please follow our Twitter if you're not already. And thank you so much for coming, everybody. And remember, follow the channel if you're not already. Bye!
Mm-hmm. We'll see you around. Peace out. And if you have any questions, comments about anything in the hobby world, feel free to ask us on those Twitter accounts too. Or if you're watching this after the fact, feel free to leave a comment on the YouTube channel in the comments below. And we'll answer it. Whatever questions you got. However, if you spoil Infinity War, I will find you, and I will break things.
Ooh, those are fighting words, yo.
Not threatening because it didn't say I'd break them, right?
Sure. Oh, Joey's tap dancing on the line.
I don't believe it. It's heresy. All right, peace out, guys.
Bye.